Okay.
Sunny day in South Florida.
All right. Hey there, REI hackers. Paul here with Kellie again. We're going to continue this trend of looking at what Kellie has done last week, what her plans are this week, and you know, letting you guys know what's going on with her and her business. So, Kellie, what did you do last week?
Okay.
Let's get right into it.
So here's my little disclaimer.
No disclaimers, just tell us. Give us the info.
So, back to my full-time job, I worked until about 9:30, 10 o'clock every single night last week, which was a little tough for productivity. And then the two mornings that I had off, I spent one with Paul, and then afterwards had gone to a networking event down in Delray, watched Frank McKinney speak on inspiration, aspiration, motivation, all these different things. Wasn't quite real estate based, it was more like personal branding and whatnot, but I definitely did some good networking. So that pretty much took up my Tuesday morning and afternoon. Wednesday, I actually had met with my new business mentor, who I have now through SCORE, which is through the Small Business Administration. It's free to use, so if you guys are struggling with the business aspect of things, me coming from an employee standpoint, not having any business experience, I think that's something I've definitely struggled with, and I actually had stumbled upon this through a book I had read, which I'm grateful for now. So I had met with him last week, and we spent about 2.5-3 hours going over solidifying a comprehensive but simple and easy to follow business plan. So I am currently working on that, finalizing things on that. I also sent out a small batch of postcards. I had a small list that was due for that, so I sent those out. The big kicker, I did not make any phone calls.
Okay, yeah, so I was going to ask you about that. What happened with the phone calls? I know you said you were... You gave us some excuses at the beginning, right? Of you were kind of, what were you doing? Priming us for this lack of action, yes?
Yeah, priming.
Okay.
So
what happened with the phone calls?
So ultimately, you know, I think my time management isn't what it could be, with how much I have going on work-wise and the phone calls I needed to make there and fitting in time to actually eat something and all these different things kind of caught up with me. So that's something I'm going to focus on more heavily this week, is getting those done and backtracking a little bit.
Okay, and so we talked a little bit before I actually started rolling the film. There's no film in this camera, it's all digital. but we had mentioned, yeah, right, wind it up. We had mentioned that, you know, maybe you should take and actually set aside blocks of time that is your only thing you have on your plate for that time, so everything else is off. And you said you're going to do that what days?
So I actually have some free time tonight. Free time. Not working until 9, 10 o'clock tonight. So after work, I'm going to make some phone calls.
Okay. So we're going to get that list of 15 calls next week?
Mm-hmm.
All right, cool. oh my God, where else was I supposed to go with this?
Today, what we did today.
Oh, yeah. So what else are you doing next week, though? Or between now and our next meeting?
So going into next week. So next week, I'm going to look to be a little more on point with my time management. That fire truck is really loud or not.
Right.
Time
loud
management.
Noises.
Exactly. using my calendar a little bit better than I've been. Definitely blocking off schedule time for things. I'm also looking to finalize my business plan through writing everything out a little more in detail. I also think that email blasts would be a lot more productive for me in terms of time-wise, so I'm going to incorporate that in with my marketing through the software that Paul and I use, the RESS software. I think that covers bases, the phone calls.
And so are you getting the email addresses from Skip Tracing as well?
Yes.
They provide that info?
Hopefully they're accurate, so we'll find that out. I'll get back to y'all on that.
Okay, cool. So you're going to make those phone calls. You're going to write more in your calendar and stick to that. You're gonna block time for certain aspects of your business, and you're gonna continue to work on your business plan. Say that's good.
Yep.
Okay. Cool. So now let's talk about what we did today, which was a surprise to me. I didn't know that I was going to go to this meeting today, but Kellie invited me, so I tagged along with her. So what did we do today, Kellie?
So part of my niche is marketing to code violations. And so I had a pretty basic knowledge of what goes on when you get a code violation, at what point it goes to the hearing. So each month in Palm Beach County, there is a hearing that is held at the main office from starting at 9 a.m. until whenever they're finished. You have contested and non-contested, whether you know the violator wants to agree that they violated and pay a fine and remedy the situation, or contested, where they don't agree to either the fine, the violation, the time, the timeline for it. So Paul and I sat through the contested hearing today for a few hours, and we had some interesting experience from that.
So, one of the things I got from it is that they don't like to see people that don't take action, especially if you're contesting it and you can't show that you've done anything to correct it, or that you're currently working on anything that will correct the violation. They don't give you any leniency, but the caveat to that is, if you can show that you are taking steps and you have verifiable action that you can show the magistrate, they work with you. And their entire thing, right, they weren't focused on collecting fines or fees or anything like that, but they were really focused on just getting those violations taken care of, especially ones that had anything to do with, like, life or safety. You know, they were pretty hot on that, and they wanted you to take action quickly, and
especially repeat violations.
Yeah.
That was a huge one for them.
Wow. I will say, if you repeat the violation over and over again, there is almost no leniency there. And I think I'm going to make a video on one in particular that maybe some of you are doing, and it'll tell a lot, but yeah, that was pretty good. So we both learned a lot today, more about the process of code violations. Everybody at the county was very welcoming to us, just sitting in to learn. So if that's a niche that you're looking at, definitely go check out your county and figure out what they do for their code violation hearings. What else, Kellie?
I think that kind of covers our basis.
Okay. Anything else you got from it? Or
no,
that
I
you
just
want to
think,
mention?
I just think, you know, attending the hearing gave me a little bit more insight and ability to speak to the process, to people that may be in that situation that, you know, it sounds like the officers do reach out multiple times. You're not calling them back, that definitely is a strike against you. So hopefully I can help in that process if somebody's afraid to talk to the officer, or you know, needs a quick solution, I can be that solution. So I definitely appreciated sitting in today.
And that's good. I like the fact that you mentioned you're learning more, so that way you can help people that are in these situations better. So
yeah,
thank you for that. And so that's all with Kellie today, so I hope you guys have a great day. Be on the lookout next week I'm going to try to post these videos on Sunday, even though we're filming them later, earlier in the week. So definitely check us out on Sunday, and we'll see you next week.